His mouth and teeth look weird. What the fuck? Pretty good card in most of those. That's it. It's a little frickin' expensive to cast, though. For a 3/3. Oh, it's a return card. Okay. Next booster. Shambling Ghoul. That's an old letters of battlefield. That's a, I don't know, the expression on that face is weird. This creature can't be blocked except a creature with flying reach. I wish they would just fucking take that off on a high health text. Just say it has flying, man. We all know what flying means. An aspiring aeronaut enters battlefield. 1/1 colorless Thopter artifact creature token flying to the battlefield.
Cool.
So it becomes a 4 or 2/4. suspicious. Oh, that's kind of interesting. Creature spirit, 2-2 flying, you cast an enchantment. Spell, 1-1 counter, blood spirit. Oh, wow, that's, that card would continue to build. Every time you cast an enchantment, it's gonna get a 1-1. That card and an enchantment deck would be pretty sweet. Tap, add, oh, special land. Tap, add one color list to your mod pool. Pay 4 and tap, target creature can't be blocked. Sweet. Next booster. Go get it. It's a lottery. Kithian's Irregulars. You know, I could've swore that's like a card. So it only costs 4. That's a good card. You got a 4-3 creature that only costs 4 mana. And as soon as you use it, it becomes a 5-4. And it has an ability to tap any target creature. That's a sweet card. Shadows of the Past, whenever a creature dies, scry 1. Which means look at the top card of your library and you get to put that on the bottom if you don't like it. You don't have to, it says you may. Each opponent loses 2 life and you gain 2 life. Activate this ability only if there are 4 or more creature cards in your graveyard. So if you're doing a graveyard deck, you can use that to kind of do like a direct damage, but that's an expensive direct damage. Of course it has the benefit of pumping you. Top 5, you get to put the creature in your hand, if there's one. But the rest of the cards go in your graveyard. Ugh. If there are 2 or more instant and/or sorcery cards, put up to 2 creature cards from other revealed cards in your hand instead. Suppression Bonds. Enchant non-land permanent. Enchanted permanent can't attack or block. And its activated abilities can't be activated. So it totally nullifies it. Can't attack, can't block, can't use its activated abilities. So yeah, that totally nullified. That's a lot like Suppression Field. Creature, Human Soldier, First Strike, Renown. That's a good card. Yeah, that's a good cheap card. Three mana, comes the first strike, 3/3. Pretty good. Alright, return to store. Now we also got enough to get another booster. No reason not to. As far as I know. Open. Soul Blade Gen. That's a pretty cool picture. So it's another flyer. When you cast a non-creature spell, creatures you control get +1/+1. That's a pretty good deal. That same Sphinx from the other picture. Whenever you draw a card, target opponent puts the top two cards of their library into the graveyard. Oh, wow. Oh, damn. Sam, seriously? Whenever you draw a card, which you get, is going to be at the beginning of every one of your turns, target opponent puts the top two cards of their library into their graveyard. If they're both non-land cards that share a color, repeat the process. So they're going to lose four cards every turn. Now, imagine you're like, I don't know, halfway through the game that pops up. So if you started with like 60 card decks and 30 are already gone, there's only 30 cards left, and then that starts popping up and they're losing four cards every time. The game can't go any more than another 7-8 rounds. That guy's gonna die. Of course, you're gonna have that card advantage if you maintain. And you continue, you pay to draw a card and discard a card. So you purposely trigger them to lose another four. Wow. Assuming that they're not. Not always gonna happen. That's not too shabby. Gearapar Gearcrafter. When he enters the field, a 1/1 colorless Thopter. Never really liked those Thopter cards. That's a pretty wicked looking thing. Undead Servant enters the battlefield. Put a 2/2 zombie creature token for each card named Undead Servant. So if you happen to have a couple of those out, that could be. Yeah, I mean, if you got like four. And actually have all four out, I mean, it can create a major problem pretty quick. Enchanted creature gets +2/+0 and has when this creature dies, draw a card. I didn't try right clicking on that. I'm gonna have to try that sometime. It looks like that's a real picture. I think that may actually be a live textured thing. Let's get rid of that fucking gun. That's an adjustment. The sound effects are fine, the music sucks. We're getting rid of that. Yay, no more music. That music blows. I took off order blockers automatically and always use optional abilities because I don't want it making those choices. I'm not quite sure what this effect is. While on, you can't make your opponent gain life, damage your own creatures, and so on. Well, no, there are some cases where you may want to do that. What the fucking vibration? I'm not using a controller. There's no vibration. Oh, those videos suck. Ain't no way I want to see them. Alright, man. Well, that's all I'm gonna do for now. I am tired. I just got a weird thing in my Twitch stream, but anyways, I'm not quite sure exactly how I'm gonna do this or how I'm gonna put these up on YouTube, or in what way to edit them. This, though, is a game that I've been very interested in seeing how it's going to play out. You know, so I'll play through the other things, put the playthroughs up, and then probably at some point, depending on how I like it, do the battles and everything else. I used to be super really good at this game. I never entered competition, but I shoulda. So it should be interesting, you know, because with today's tech and being able to just challenge people, be interested to see how it is. It's always a good, fun, calm game that, you know, if nothing else, you can just kind of sit back, relax, have fun with your friends, you know, and play games while chatting with people that are watching on Twitch if people are dropping in the channels. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoy these videos. If you have any questions, suggestions, or anything, make sure to drop them below the video. And you know, if you like the videos and what you see, remember to subscribe and share the videos. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you're having fun. You guys have a great day. Okay, well, that's a good place to stop for this show, but make sure to come back and watch the next episode. And thank you for watching Crush'em TV. Make sure to subscribe or follow, whether you watch on Twitch or YouTube, and sign up for Twitter so that you get updates. I thank you guys for watching, subscribing, and supporting the channel and what I do. If you have any suggestions, anything you want to see, or just want to send me a message, you can hit me through every one of those forums. So you guys have a great day, and thanks for watching.